Hello, I'm Joshua Carr. What I'd like to show you this week, because I keep getting requests for this, is I put together a series of challenge cases that are on my website at kahrrealestate.com. I'd like you to just walk you through a very simple case. I may end up eventually doing videos for all of them, but this first one is called Abacus. And again, if you're interested in downloading this, you can just go to my website at kahrrealestate.com. You can download it, you can flesh it out, you get the idea. So, Abacus case. In this case, it's 100,000 feet. This information here, I just copied over from here. I've got, as you can see, a purchase price. I've got acquisition costs, say 3% of 14 million. I've got a purchase price. That's a total purchase, which is just 14 plus 420. That's the only thing here that is not a formula. That's just me, or sorry, not an input. That's just me adding those two things together. I've got my cap rate on sale, my closing costs, rent growth. You can basically see I took the stuff from over here and I copied it over here. And the goal is to be able to build and solve these problems. In this case, a cap rate, a cash on cash yield. You get the idea. Okay, so let's take it out for a spin. Let me take the simple information and see where we go. The only bit of information here that is actually just useless is where it says under financing that the term is 10 years. Since we're holding it for 10 years, the fact the term is 10 years is kind of meaningless. This would really only matter if the term was like, say, 5 years and it was forcing a refinancing. In this case, it's not doing that. Okay, groovy. So let's get going here. So the first thing to do is we're going to have a line for rental income, and I'm going to have some years. Oops. Years. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You get the idea. And I don't actually need all of the spaces after the decimal. So year one is going to be 100,000 feet times $20 a foot. Okay, pretty painless. That's a start. Of course, in this case, we're going to have growth 3% on rent, 3% for expenses. It's always funny to me that everyone uses 3% as a default, even though, inflation is rarely exactly 3%, but nonetheless, that's what we're doing. Now, I find the least painful way of doing this is to have this be 3%. And then whenever I build this, I just like to track that across because then it's, pretty easy. It just grows at 3%. Life is good. Okay. This way also, if someone changes the rates later, it'll vary. So 200 times 1 plus 3%. Take that, copy it across. Here, I've been messing with this earlier, so I got to make sure this is all formatted to be like, numbers, not percentages. Vacancy, on the other hand, is going to be the 2 million times negative 5%, dollar sign. Take that. Copy that across. That'll give me an effective rental income of that. Again, and me filling that's just Control R to fill. That seems to work. For expenses, I got three of them. One, two, three. And don't get me wrong, if this was a real case, I'd probably worry more about formatting, like if I was doing it like for a job thing. But I think it's nice if you can just bang it out and then come back later and mess around with the formats. Let's first get the math right, and then I can worry about making pretty. Okay, so 550 times 100,000 feet. And for kicks, I'm going to fix the C5, fix that. This way I can just copy, paste, copy, paste. Take that times 1 plus the rate of growth. And you know what I'll do, because I want to copy it down, is I'm going to press F4 a couple times. I'm going to fix the row but float the column. By putting a dollar sign in front of the 27 and nothing in front of the column, it'll fix the row. By that I mean, and float the column. By that I mean, when I copy it down, it's still doing row 27, column E. And when I copy it across, you know, again, fix the row, float the column, it populates. And oopsie, here, let me just drag these little bad boys over by one more year, because I'm going to need year 11. That's going to come up later when I try to do valuation. I'll explain why in a bit. Anyway, so that gives me my operating expenses, which will be a sum of those three. Take that, populate, and while I'm at it, and this is me making pretty, I apologize, just throwing in some lines. That's going to get me to my net operating income, which is going to be this minus that, populate. Great, so those are my years. So now I've got simple net operating income. Now, one related question that comes up is, it says, hey, I want to do my going in cap rate, my cash on cash yield, you know, unlevered cash flows. Let's deal with unlevered cash flows first, because I think that's the least painful thing to deal with. So to do an unlevered cash flow, or unlevered IRR, what I need to do is a very simple box. I basically have to have the total purchase price. And here, let me throw in some years. Again, we're going to be doing 10-year hold. The money in is going to be negative 14.4. In other words, that's what we're buying it for. That's the purchase price and the closing costs of 14.4 million. The NOI, the net operating income, is going to be equal to 10 years of cash flow. Oopsie. Come on. Jeez, that's annoying. There we go. The sale price is going to be a little trickier. To do the sale price, we got to do a couple things. First thing is, I got to calculate it. So the NOI in year 11 is going to be equal to 1.478. The cap rate, as we on sale, as we saw earlier, was equal to 9.5%. That was given to us. That's going to give us a sale price of this divided by this. The logic being that if you're selling it at the end of year 10, you're using year 11's cash flow, because, you know, that's what the next person is going to make. Just as I might buy it today at time zero based on what I'll make in year one, I'll sell it at the end of year 10 based on what I'll make in year 11. Again, I think that's pretty straightforward. The closing costs, we already know, are going to be equal to 2.25%. Which means sale, we're going to spend this to sell it, which means the net sales proceeds is going to be equal to this minus that. Again, I might worry about formatting if I care, but you get the idea. Great. So I sell it for this. I set $350,000 on fire because brokers and legal and stuff like that. And this is now what I get, which means the net sales proceeds is going to equal this, which means the result of that is going to be the sum of these three cells, populate, which means the IRR is going to be IRR of that. So according to this, the internal rate of return is 8.9%. And the other question I can't answer really quick here is, what's the year one cap rate? Well, that's also not that hard to solve. If we know the NOI in year one is this, and we, does it ask for purchase price or total purchase price? I guess just purchase price. Okay, it's a little unclear. I'm going to assume it means just purchase price, which was $14 million, which means the going in cap rate is 7.86. So that's my unlevered cash flow. And, you know, that's a pretty good natural break point, and that took 10 minutes. So let's take a break here. We'll come back and then we'll do the second vid and we'll, you know, throw in some debt. Cool. And again, if you're into this sort of stuff, check out my website at kahrrealestate.com. And as I always like to say whenever I end one of these videos, keep on building better models. Thanks.